stands by his side.
Sit.
For the select few, this process might make them. But for the majority of these celebrities...
God!
It will completely break them.
Hands. Walk.
Come on, let's go!
In this series, 16 celebrity recruits will leave their glamorous lives behind. They will be put through the most grueling stages of SAS selection by an elite team of ex-special forces soldiers.
Honesty, integrity, trust. Everything we've installed you from day one. Everything!
No allowances or exceptions will be made.
I'm not scared of getting dirty, but I'm going to have to change these. I can just about open my car door.
Whoa.
My mum does not want me to do this. She's scared I'm going to get injured. I think she's really, really not looking forward to that.
I've seen pressure.
I need support! Now!
So what I'm going to face on this course is water off a duck's back.
Take it down!
Like an injured slug.
Let's help your boat!
No other test asks as much.
You got it, let's go!
Well done, Soto.
Or means as much.
Well done.
To the few who make it through.
Welcome to your worst nightmare.
I am nervous right now.
Get this bag off my head now.
16 celebrities.
Oh my God. Everyone just breathe.
Are about to embark on a condensed version of SAS selection.
I'm scared.
Celebrities are everything that you shouldn't be in the Special Forces. You need to be someone who is self-sufficient, robust, resilient.
Get on with it! Face forward!
This course is like an awakening for celebrities.
Go! Go!
Everyone thinks that they can push through their fears until they are faced with them and they realise how uncomfortable they are.
Stand up, mate. Turn around.
The people that can do that are the only people that will be stood there at the end.
Put your hands on a handrail. Step forward. Step up.
I'm quite used to being in a hostile environment. Politics, by its nature, has hostility built into it.
Still?
Yeah, I've had my share of hostility.
Just look at me.
One of the things about having been the health secretary in the pandemic is almost everybody has a personal view on you, and who knows what the DS will think.
So that smirk on your face?
I think I'm about to find out.
Follow the pontoon around, don't touch it. Zip it. Coconut.
I'm 51, I'm 5'1". I've got 3 children, you know, I've got a pocket full of crystals. I'm the least likely candidate for this course. This would be the toughest thing I've ever done, which terrifies the crap out of me.
I am excited, I'm ready, I think. Even if inside I'm going, oh my God.
Put a smile off your face.
I can't hide how I'm feeling very well, which is really bad considering I'm an actor.
I'm a sore loser. Being an ex-footballer, that's the nature of the game. I'm very competitive. You don't play not to win. The worst thing to happen would be quitting. That's a no-no, and I don't think I could handle that.
Out in the jungle, the weather changes quicker than it does back home. It is rapid. Before you know it, you're in a monsoon and it's battering you. You've got to be prepared for that. The humidity alone rots you as a human. When it starts to rain, it just speeds the process up. It will chew you up and spit you out.
Let's go! Move with purpose!
The jungle is like a living creature, and its mood changes. And when the weather turns bad, that's the jungle in a fucking terrible mood.
I've been through enough shit in my life to realize who I am. But what I am really interested about knowing is what I am capable of.
Just look at me. You know, stand. Just look at me.
This course is deemed as one of the hardest things that anyone will ever, ever do, physically and mentally. Ah. So I desperately feel it's a pivotal moment in my life to figure out to myself, has the past given me that ability to be really strong in the future?
20 years ago on Pop Idol, I become the UK's biggest loser. I think the public perception of me is young, shy boy. That's what they saw all those years ago. And so I'm looking forward to showing the public that I'm a man now with a beard and I'm a bit more stronger than I was then.
Juggling on the spot! I will be counting one of you. Do not get caught fucking cheating. Everybody understand? Yeah. 20 burpees, go!
Do the exercises correctly or you will pay.
These celebrities may think they know what fear is, but this course will give them a whole new perspective to the term.
When I say go, you're gonna sprint as fast as you can down this road.
Stand by.
Just the environment alone is gonna give them shock and fear.
Go! You're running like a fucking ostrich.
The jungle, the DS.
Go.
And the constant pressure. We'll see who's who.
Go! Get over here!
If you never try something, you don't fail. If you don't fail, you don't learn.
Run the edge!
I know that this course is going to be extremely intense and I don't know how I'm going to deal with it.
Around the edge!
Fern McCann's even told me that this is harder than giving birth.
Get on your number and stand still.
I don't know how good my pain threshold is. I stubbed my toe recently and it absolutely killed.
Through the gap!
Welcome to Vietnam. Welcome to your worst nightmare. Stood in front of you right now is over 5 decades of operational and training experience in this jungle environment. We are your DS. At all times, you will address us as staff. Do you understand?
Yes, yes, sir.
This course is going to be the hardest thing you've done in your life. It's fucking horrendous. The longer you stay on this course, the better version of you you will become. I fucking promise you that. Listen in.
Hancock, number one, right here.
Right. When you get your name and your number called out, look at me. Come to me for your number. When you've got your number, grab a Bergen.
Fuck it. Be polite. Thank you, staff.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
If they turn up with the wrong attitude, thinking it's some celebrity boot camp...
Argent, number two!
Get over here, nasty thing.
We'll just keep hammering them until they stop acting like idiots.
Pull up your pants. Nasty. Thank you, staff.
Thank you, staff.
Get over there.
There's something you find funny, is that? Get that burger up above your head, number four. Get it above your head now! I'll give you something to fucking laugh about.
We will drill it out of them until that attitude is dropped.
Still finding funny?
Yes, sir.
I didn't think you fucking would. Put it down.
We're here to show people what they can actually achieve, but to be able to do that, we've got to be hard on them.
Take the clothing out of the bag, I get changed.
Go! Quick as you can!
We're hard on ourselves, so we're not going to go easy on these lot. And if they don't like that, they can fuck off.
Get your belt on properly, number two. Fucking painful to watch. The bag of shit.
We throw everything into this course and we do it for their own benefit.
Come on, then. Oi, shut the fuck. Who did that?
You can fucking stand by.
Come on, then, up here.
I'm just this girl from Newcastle. I pretended to be a pop star for 23 years. Don't really know what I'm doing.
Get up here, you clown. Stand by doesn't mean stand there.
I get a kick out of being scared. I just know I'm going to love it.
Right, stand at the end of the bed.
Right, this is your accommodation. This is where you live, enjoy life. This place is to be kept immaculate. Your water, vessels, bottles and the bladder, they will always be topped up to the brim. Right, cheer up, smile.
You're in your own time. You all right? Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Oh, I'm such an idiot.
Come on.
Totally pissed on from the beginning.
Listen, stop.
Stop.
Oh, my God.
Oh, Gareth.
Oh, I mean, that was straight to the deep end, wasn't it?
Literally.
I knew this was going to be frightening.
Yeah.
But it was still way beyond.
Yeah.
This is absolutely insane.
Oh, that's bad. Oh, that's bad.
Throughout the selection process, Chief Instructor Billy and his DS will assess the performances of the recruits.
Mia's actually got a brain of a plant.
Earmarking those who are standing out and decide who to apply extra pressure to.
Number one.
Focus, but he brings with him baggage.
Ooh, 31.
He's coming for a big reason, isn't he?
Yeah.
So let's get ready to dig into him right from the off.
Mm.
Number two.
He's highlighted himself straight away.
Your arse is hanging out.
Oh, I think I've broken my belt.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he's never wore trousers before, but his fucking arse is on show and he hasn't done his belt up properly once.
He's going to have issues.
He's going to be a nightmare. Number 12. He's a unit, isn't he?
You know, I've never talked with my feet before.
Haven't you?
No, I haven't. Regular with my balls, but then... But never my feet.
He brings the heat.
Yeah.
But then I'm not sure how long he can sustain it.
Yeah. All right. Anything else?
All right.
Okay. Thanks. Done.
After 52 hours of continuous rain, the base is flooded with 16 inches of water.
Do you reckon it's going to be raining every day?
It's sunny outside now.
Is it actually really?
No.
Honestly, I've just got pure swamp in my breast.
I've got swamp in my knickers. That's going to give me rash. Swamp bush.
Recruits, let's go!
Fucking hell.
Oh, no!
Why is it now I feel like I need a shit?
Let's go!
Move out!
Come on, get up there! Stay in formation, let's go!
I don't think my willpower has ever been tested like this before. I have no game plan. I'm completely winging it, so I'll just take whatever comes at me.
Go away! Get here!
I'm from a really privileged part of the UK. I went to an amazing school.
Let's go!
So I just feel like I've lived my life in a bubble.
Cover down behind a harness!
I feel like that's all gonna be ripped away from me, and I don't know how I feel about it.
Begin rigging up. Do it now.
To test the recruits' ability to handle fear, the DS have brought them to one of the most terrifying of all military tests, the Trinasium.
To overcome your fear of heights, calm your mind, focus, and execute. Stand by!
Oh, my God.
Advance!
In a task taken from Special Forces selection, the recruits must traverse two parallel bars, suspended 50 feet above the ground.
Oh my God.
During the crossing, they will be required to complete multiple maneuvers.
Hold the position.
Oh my God.
Touch your toes. Stand up.
I can't touch my toes. My legs ache.
Advance.
The demonstration you just witnessed is a prime example of what you are to expect in the special operations community.
Absolutely petrified.
Number one, switch the fuck on.
essential that every single Special Forces operator can conduct operations at height.
The recruits are being put through jungle warfare training and are about to take on the Trinasium.
Number two. Off you go. Get a move on!
Attempting the crossing.
Keep it going!
Is recruit number two, reality TV star, James Argent.
My biggest fear is how intense this course is. I just don't know if physically I'm gonna be there yet.
Let's go, two!
And that's because a year ago I was extremely overweight and I was getting bigger. I couldn't even tie my own shoelaces. So that's why I decided to have a gastric sleeve operation.
Sit down on the floor. Now that was like a task in itself. Stand there.
I feel much happier, healthier, but sometimes I feel weak. But in terms of how much I want it, I know that I'm gonna give it my all.
If you fuck it up, yeah. The only way is down, not fucking Essex.
Come on, number two, shuffle forward.
Oh no, I'm not very good at this.
That's not even the start, walk to the start. There you go. Keep it coming.
Let go of that rope.
Oh, wow.
Take the roller boots off. Now release.
Don't rush it. Let go of the rope.
Sorry. Shaky Stevens.
Shuffle. Lean back. You're leaning too far forward. Shuffle. Slowly. Let go of that rope! It's your last warning.
OK.
One more fucking time, I'm going to run across there and knock you off it.
Dig deep now, mate.
Stop making silly noises and keep moving.
I'm going to squeal like a little girl.
Bend, touch your toes, stand up straight.
Okay.
Go on then. Touch your toes. Touch your toes. Stand up straight. Shuffle. All the way to the obstacle now.
Throw it down. Let go of the rope.
Fuck, sorry.
Get the fuck off that rope. Go.
This side.
Fucking go, or I'll come and throw you off.
Let go of that rope. Let go of the rope.
Fuck.
Fail.
I don't think this is for me.
Next!
Fucking hell.
Get on with it!
Next up is recruit number 11.
Come on, we're running out of daylight.
TV personality, Danielle Lloyd.
Oh, God. People probably think I've just lived some glamorous life and I want to change people's perceptions. I'm actually a strong person.
Have a look down.
Yeah.
No, go on, have a look down.
Can see.
Open your eyes. Make sure you can see through those eyelashes.
It's only been in the last few years that I've realised now I can be a really strong woman. I've got my 5 kids and I've got to be strong for them.
Are you scared of heights?
Yeah.
Have you been up at height before?
Yeah. When I freak out, I scream, I shout and I swear.
Advance. Good position. Well done.
Oh, fuck. My mum actually did say to me, she went, please don't swear. Fuck.
Do not grab that rope anymore.
Try and tough.
Okay, what I want you to do now is stand still. Stand perfectly still. Don't touch the rope. Touch your toes. Leg straight. Nailed it. Now let's go, momentum. Okay, you've got an obstacle to cross in a minute.
Yes.
You have to go for it. Composure now, composure. Stand up, take a breath.
It's making me nervous watching it.
Go.
Don't touch that rope.
You know, one more time, you're going off the side or down the middle.
I'm trying, Saf. I'm trying.
Try harder.
I'm fucking shit.
Shut myself. Up. I don't want to hear it. Just do it. Keep going. Keep going.
Fuck.
Keep coming. Stand still. Stand right there.
Nice.
You overcome a lot of fears there, didn't you?
Yeah.
Take a breath. Realise where you are. That's a good effort. Well done.
Thank you, Saf.
Take your hands off the rope. Stand by. Advance.
I can't.
You can. Like a baby walking to its mother for the first time. That's all you've got to think about.
I was never particularly sporty as a younger person. I was slow, cack-handed, terrible hand-to-eye coordination. I was shit. So the idea of this course terrifies me somewhat.
Pathetic! Hold it! That's good. Good body position.
I'm not a fan of roller coasters, bungee jumping. Someone told me to jump out of a plane, I'd look down and be like, hell no.
Go! Whoa. You've got this, let's go.
There's like two sides of me. Love going out, getting pampered, but then there's a side of me that loves getting sweaty in the gym and not afraid to get dirt up her nails.
Fail, number 10. You got it, let's go! Miserable fail. Good, you're nailing it now.
Losing my arm was the best thing that's ever happened to me.
Arm out, balance.
Since losing my arm, I've always thrown myself every challenge. The first military injury serviceman to win gold at Paralympic Games. Probably one of the hardest things on the course is going to be doing my shoelaces.
You're leaning forward. Keep it straight. Keep it. Go. Fail. Fucking hell. How does that feel?
Good.
Good.
Yeah.
You nailed it. Well done.
Thank you.
Good effort.
Ah, Mr. Hancock with the silent hand.
Number one stuff.
All right, you moody cow.
Next to attempt the crossing.
What, fear of heights?
Not particularly, but nobody wants to fall, do they?
Stand back over there.
It's recruit number one, former health secretary, Matt Hancock.
I've been in some of the most high-pressure situations that you can imagine.
Stand by, arms forward, advance.
In those really high-pressure moments, I hope I can draw on what I've experienced.
Leg forward, hips forward.
Especially to know that you just gotta keep putting one foot in front of the other.
That's it!
Each step, even when you think you can't take any more, you can take one step.
Keep the fucking rhythm going, number one.
And if you imagine the finish line is just five steps away, you could always make it.
Slow it down. Stand up! Hey!
Fucking dismount. What the fuck happened there?
Fucking Cirque du Soleil, was it?
That was a fucking Fredwardo, or in English, fail.
Bollocks. Wanted to show us how to do a somersault there.
I didn't want to grab the bar stuff.
Catastrophic fail, number one.
Yeah, thanks.
You complete and utter buffoon. Get ready to move. On me. All right, let's go.
Close these gaps, quick as you can. Get up there, number six. Close the gaps.
Acoustics. Yeah, can have a acoustic race for the camp. Just drop your sticks at the top.
Just getting them raking the foot, then.
OK.
The Tranasium.
Nobody's strongly positive, if I'm honest. This lot at the minute, they're just not with it. They literally are just coasting along. I don't think they're taking it serious enough at the minute. What we need to do is really turn it up. Who came when and what? Rudy?
I don't even know where to begin with two. Obviously a fail. I think he failed so soon that I didn't have any notes to write down.
Yeah, I mean, he wasn't the quickest to fall, but he wasn't far from the start point anyway.
Yeah, he got about a meter, right? Fail.
Yeah. Well, then we had number 11, afraid of heights. Her hands were on the ropes, touched the bars, but she did make it all the way across.
Yeah, it was an interesting fucking move across there. She ain't gonna win anything on glamour or style, but she got across and she was delighted. So it was good for her.
Pass.
Next.
Number one, all I have is fail.
He took a nosedive through the fucking, the rigging. He stepped on, he went about 8 inches.
Right.
His attitude. I didn't want to grab the bar stuff. You know, really cocky about it. I think he's come heavily guarded because of who he is. He's expecting everybody to immediately be against him. That's not the case. You know, you have a crack with everybody. And it seems he's taking things too fucking personal.
Quite frankly, I get the impression that he's got a bit of an attitude and he thinks that he's above everyone.
Chip on his shoulder.
Well, we'll take that chip away very soon. He's worthy of a chat. Happy with that?
Yeah. Roger. Happy.
Let's go.
It was the thin white one I was looking for. Thank you.
Number one!
Coming!
After his failure on the previous task...
Right, number one, stone facing that.
Fuck yeah.
The DS want to delve deeper...
Why? Why did he do that?
...into recruit number one, Matt Hancock's psychological state.
Stand still, put your hands by your side. Stand still.
Stand.
Relax. You look like you're about to get executed. How are you doing?
Not as well as I'd hoped.
Why?
I've let myself down a couple of times.
Where do you feel you've let yourself down?
I shouldn't have fallen off the bars.
It was a pretty good fucking fall.
I made a total tit out of myself.
Why are you here?
Because I want to push myself, basically. I've been through something really big. Didn't end the way I'd wanted it to.
What was that?
Well, I handled the pandemic, didn't I?
Then you tell me.
Yeah, well, I did. It was the biggest experience of my life. It'd be very hard to see a bigger professional experience than being the health secretary in a pandemic. I pushed myself in the past, but I want to test the limits. See how deep I can dig.
How do you feel about how it all ended then with regard to the pandemic?
I was managing a very difficult situation in a professional sense. Mm-hmm. Thought I'd done a pretty good job. And then...
But then it fucking fell apart.
I fell in love with somebody who I'd known since I was at university and worked closely with in the pandemic. And I had to resign from government.
Let's put this in layman terms, number one. Basically, the rules that you've established as a country to follow, you think, you know what, I'm above this, I'm bigger than the system.
Yeah, I didn't think that.
I'm talking. Fucking listening, yeah? You think, fuck this, I'm gonna have a bit of that. I'm gonna break the rules here, I'm gonna break the rules there, on a number of occasions. From sitting on this side of the table, that's exactly how it went down. From the background.
Yeah.
Where you come from, the very foundations, is honesty and integrity. So put the barriers down.
Yeah.
And explain it properly, yeah?
Well, the truth is, I was very careful not to break any of the laws. But what I didn't think was that there was still guidance. It wasn't legally binding by that point. But it was still the guidance that we were putting out.
The point being is this guidance is stuff that you wrote. Like, when
yeah,
we...
Wait.
Yeah. When we dish out a set of orders, we fucking live our life by that as well.
Yes.
With integrity. As far as I'm concerned, you showed weak leadership, allowing things to get in the way of a position that you were entrusted to hold.
Yeah. I regret the lack of leadership at the end.
Going back to this course...
And by the way...
Oi!
Sorry.
Shut the fuck up. This is the issue. This is what I'm about to talk about. Mm-hmm. We are here to put people under pressure. We do that to see how people respond. Outside of this course, you might have been subjected to no end of fucking shit. And quite frankly, we don't care. This is a clean slate. If you're stood out there and you are feeling like you're getting shit thrown at you, that isn't personal. Do you see where I'm going with this?
I do.
It means curb your attitude and think for 10 seconds before engaging your mouth or a facial expression.
Understood.
This is the place to throw it all on the fucking table. Leave nothing in reserve. Show us what you've got and you'll learn something from this, 100%.
God!
Sit up. Hands. Walk. Don't you worry.
I have self-doubt about things that I have done.
Oh, yeah.
Did you cry, Matt?
I didn't cry. I'm not very good at... I'm not much of a crier.
One of the things about this course is it will get down to the fundamental truth.
Matt, what did they ask you? Like, what kind of questions?
COVID, pandemic.
And push me in a way that I haven't been pushed, and I'll find out more about myself.
You've probably answered that question a million times anyway. Yeah.
Although they're better at getting under your skin than your average interviewer.
Yeah, true.
Do you want a hug?
No.
No.
I just hope that I know enough about myself that I can get through it.
desperately need to go to the toilet today.
Oh, really? I always have a morning fart.
Oh, yeah.
Someone was fart. I heard someone fart.
It wasn't me.
I was laughing my head off. I just said... money.
Recruit, let's go! Stay in formation, let's go!
At the beginning of the course, the celebs' fear levels are going to be sky high.
Suffer in silence.
So that's why we throw them into a violent situation. It is a massive shock to the system. It brings them into the game straight away.
Listen up to the DS.
It is a baptism of fire. He opens their eyes to what they've signed up for, and some of them will not like it.
Right, everything we do as a special forces operator ultimately culminate in the application of extreme violence. It's not nice. It is a byproduct of what we do. What you are about to do is called milling. It's not boxing. It is stood toe to toe with an opponent and punching the living fuck out of them. Now what you're going to do is take your Bergens off, place them down in front of you. Get your hats off. Number five.
First to fight is recruit number five, ex-Premier League footballer, Jermaine Pennant.
Right, number one.
His opponent is recruit number one, former Health Secretary, Matt Hancock.
Right, go on then, get gloved up. Set of gloves and a head guard. Yeah.
You're getting the mindset, yeah?
Yeah.
Controlled aggression, it's all in here.
I've had endless death threats over the vaccine, but I haven't been punched since I was a teenager. I've got no idea, actually, how I'll respond to it.
For this 1 minute, he's the enemy. Start switching on.
OK.
If I'm specifically instructed to fight somebody, I find that difficult, but that's the whole purpose of the course, is to follow instructions.
OK.
Let's have it, yeah?
All right.
Listening to DS.
So that is part and parcel of it.
Good to go.
I don't think I've ever even got in a fight. Arguments, yeah, plenty of them.
Channel aggression straight up the middle. And then when you hear stop, you turn it off.
I can handle myself in a fight. I'm no Mike Tyson, but I'll give it a go.
I haven't got my mouth guard in.
Don't let me hit you in the face then.
Right, come together. Well, remember, this ain't fucking boxing. I don't care what you've done before. It's just straight on punching. Someone goes to the floor, keep punching till I say stop. Understood?
Understood.
Right, fists up. Stand by.
Fight! Go, go, go! One, one! Throw some fucking punches! Knock his head off!
Brutal.
That's it, let's go, five!
Recruit number five, Jermaine, takes an early advantage.
Come on, number one! Start throwing some punches! Come on, number one!
Number one not fights back to stay in the contest.
Take him down, number five! Take him down!
Stop! Stand up, get in here.
Quickly!
It's amazing. Leave it all out there.
Right. Reasonably pathetic fight. However, number five, you won that one. Number one, you lost. Get your gloves off. Hurry up.
Come on, let's go. Gum shields out.
Okay.
Yeah. Fucking fail, number one. Good effort, number five.
Right, number 14.
Next up is recruit number 14, singer Siva Kanaswaran.
Number 12.
He will be fighting former Welsh rugby international, recruit number 12, Gareth Thomas.
Go on then, get gloved up.
Let's go! You got your gum shield in? All right, good to go. Throw that helmet on.
I don't like conflict. I avoid conflict.
Keep throwing shots, warrior mindset, warrior mindset.
The only fight I've ever been in was with my brothers, and that lasted like 20 years, and I lost every single one of them. So no, I don't like fights. I just don't even like the thought of combat.
Punch until we say stop. If someone goes down, keep going. All out aggression.
Even though I'm living with HIV, I want to be a physical example that I can physically and mentally do the most difficult challenges put to any human being on this planet.
Gloves up.
Fight! Go! Big right hand! Take his head off! That's aggression! That's what we're looking for! Fight back, 14! Fight back!
early in the fight, number 12 Gareth takes a commanding lead.
Don't give up, Forcey! Do not give up! That's it, good fight!
He's tired, mate.
After his explosive start,
don't give up, 12! Do not give up!
Recruit number 12 Gareth is showing signs of fatigue.
Who wants it?
Allowing number 14 Siva back into the bout.
That's it, 14! Come on, 14! Find out well to win!
Stop! Stand there. Right, stand up. Some pride about yourselves. Good effort there, both of you. You just fucking picked it. Unfortunately, you just fucking didn't put it in at the beginning. Good effort, though. Go over there, get on glove.
12, drop your kit down here. Stand over there. Good effort, 14. That's what we're looking for, right? Good effort, 12. This Millen! Get stuck in! Finish him!
The job as a special forces operator is uncomfortable.
The fucking guy's in the fight!
You know, I don't take pleasure in engaging in violence.
Do not stop punching!
But it's a byproduct of going to war.
That's it! Don't give up!
You'll see people that are so petrified they don't want to get involved.
Use the pain!
And then you'll see people that are so hyped up that they then can't turn it off. And we don't want either of those. You almost want a non-emotional fighter.
Come on, get rid of him!
There's no place for fear in the special forces because it doesn't lend itself to good decision-making.
Stop! Stand there.
That's insane.
Get your mouth guard in.
Next to fight.
Quick as you can.
Is reality TV star.
Stop switching on.
Recruit number 2, James Argent.
I've been massively inspired by Tyson Fury. He's gone through similar mental health problems like myself, drinking drugs and overeating.
Get your head in the zone.
Okay.
Serious?
Sure. I wouldn't feel comfortable about hitting a woman, but if I have to do it, I'll do it. I'm definitely not scared.
Warrior mindset.
James's opponent is recruit number 6.
Stay tight.
Great British Olympian, Perry Shake Straighten.
Full power, maximum effort.
Having been an athlete, I know pain. I know heartache. I know hard work. But maybe my fears will get in the way of my ability because I don't feel like I know how to control it. But I don't let it get in the way and I just get on with it. And that is the mentality that I will be channeling on the course.
Fight! Go, 6!
Go on, 6!
Go forward, number 2! Go backwards, go forward! Throw some punches, number 2! You've got a job to do, number 2! Fucking do it!
Early in the contest, recruit number 2, James.
Fuck's sake, number 2! Fucking combat!
Is reluctant to fight.
Get involved, you twat! Stop fucking dancing and fight! Get your fist up! Combat! A fucking spawn! Fucking dick splash! Let's go!
Stop!
With James's refusal to fight back, the DS call an end to the bout.
Stand up, pride. Good effort, number 6. You won 2. That was fucking shite. Go and take your gear off and stand over there with the DS.
Is Millen number 2 not sparring? Fucking fail. Take your gum shield out. Fucking pathetic. Weak.
Nah, I didn't want to hurt her. Oh, could you tell? Yeah, you can tell. That's why they was a bit mad at me, wasn't it?
Fucking pathetic.
First time I've taken a punch to the tits. Thank you.
But it's fucking not nice.
It is what it is. Well done.
Are you okay?
I wanted a proper fight and I just didn't feel that I could steam into Perry. I got it wrong because they said I lost and I was weak. That's not enough for them to kick me out, is it?
You went to now.
Yeah.
Get on, Perry!
Oh, for fuck.
You better be quick.
Oh, I'm busting.
Whoa.
Argy, come on.
Every recruit will be expected to have great personal discipline.
How do I get this on?
Oh, mate, why have you taken it off?
Fuck.
That is the way they dress, their timing, their punctuality.
When I say fucking move, I mean move. When I say 5 minutes or 6 minutes, I mean 6 minutes. That's yours, you bag of fucking shit.
This is all discipline. Discipline is the foundation to everything in the SF world.
Get it now. Grab that belt. Come out here. Everybody, 30 burpees. While fucking numbnuts here watches you. Stand and face them.
You've got to be a good individual to be part of a good team. You should be prepared for whatever comes at you. What you shouldn't do is turn into an headless chicken like you haven't got a fucking clue what day it is.
Tell them to keep going, number two.
Keep going.
Tell them to keep going.
Keep going.
You need to have your shit together and be able to make sure that everybody around you are doing exactly the same. You're taking care of each other.
I'm done. I'm done.
Stand over there. If you're told to be on parade, I suggest you go 2 minutes early. Start acting like you want a beer. You fucking moot. Right, everybody except number two, 20 press-ups. Go. You stand as you are, number two.
There's various types of punishment, and blanket punishment means the whole team gets punished for somebody's error.
Keep going. Tell them to hurry up. Tell them to hurry up.
Hurry up.
That is then to hopefully try and get the team to gel.
Hurry up.
And look after each other better. So not to allow one individual to create the crack that gets you punished. It's as simple as that.
Get on your feet. Stand still. You fucking move one more time, number two. When I say go, disappear back to your accommodation, you run. And I mean run. Go! Don't be last! Move with purpose, get going!
Fucking hell. Oh, I love Arj. I love Arj. I love Arj.
Sorry. No, I'm actually sorry.
We're going to need to watch you like a Hulk.
No, I know what I've got to do.
You're the only one that's giving us burpees, you nutter.
Make sure this doesn't happen again.
Sort yourself out.
Recruit! Number two!
Number two. What?
Downstairs. Fucking move on.
Good stuff.
Having failed both of today's tasks,
gonna move on.
The DS want to find out more about recruit number two, James Argent.
Hands down both sides. Sit.
Pull your chair in a little bit.
Are you like a naturally smiley person, or you're nervous, or what is it?
Yeah,
because it's kind of fucking irritating, if I'm honest. It's almost like you're acting the fool. You're fidgeting. It's fucking annoying.
Hmm.
Why are you here?
I just kind of felt like this is the right time for me to take on a challenge like this. Just over a year ago, I was 27 stone.
27 stone?
Yeah. And now I'm like 14 and a half. I just feel like me being here is, I feel like a sense of achievement, the fact that I'm even here and I'm taking part. This would be like the ultimate for me if I was to do well in this.
You're a good enough kid. You're a bit of an idiot on the course. But if you've got the mind to do what you did with your fitness and to take control of your life, that's what you're gonna need to do here.
How do you feel about discipline? How do you feel about authority? How does it feel to you when you're being shouted at? Are you struggling with it?
Yeah, I suppose it's new to me, like in certain ways.
Well, I'm gonna tell you, fucking grip it and grip it fast. Mm. If you want a beer, you've really gotta buck up. Okay. You either get with the program or you're going out that gate, all right? You can obviously do well. You've just done amazing things to lose all that weight, stay focused, stay disciplined. Don't come here to play the fool, because I'll tell you what, people will suffer because of you, and you will suffer.
Yeah.
We haven't got time to piss around, wise up, and act like you want to be here.
Yeah.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do want to be here.
Well, you better show it. You'll be fucking ready. God!
Stand up. Hands together. Thumbs up.
He is nervous, yeah. But I also believe he's playing a bit of the fucking fool.
Well, that's gonna stop.
Well, that will stop.
Yeah, right on.
It's that fucking sharpish.
Fast as you can, number two. Get started.
I feel like I'm able to take a lot of things in my stride. I've built up quite a bit of resilience, I've been through quite a lot, and I'd like to think that nothing phases me too much.
You all right?
Yeah.
How was it?
Yeah, it was all right.
They're trying to wind you up?
No, it's all good.
Dig deep.
Yeah, it's down to me now, isn't it? I've got to take it seriously.
When I'm out of my comfort zone, I definitely feel vulnerable, for sure. And I think one of my biggest flaws is that I always ask for reassurance.
I didn't expect to get a sixth kid, but I will take you on, Arch, as one of my own.
I don't know if the DS is going to give me the reassurance that I need.
It's all good.
And I feel like that could affect me a bit. I just really need to believe in myself more.
You can do it. You've got it in you.
Next time...
Hurry the fuck up!
Hit the door down!
Get out of here!
Go, soldier!
Mindset is key in the SF world.
Get your fucking stomach!
If you have a weak mindset,
number one!
You will fail.
You're fucking pathetic, you're like a crab!